Well, I think it's quite difficult for me to say only one, but I think the most memorable moment was back in 1997 when we agreed on Kyoto Protocol. At that time, I worked as the kind of local staff, so like I serve as the conference officer in Kyoto. So I was in the room when the Mr. Estrada just banged the gavel. So that was a quite touching moment for me because that was my first international agreement I observed and also I worked for, I mean, directly and indirectly. And right after that, I had a chance to work with the UN, work for the UN, but a completely different area. So I started to pile up the, you know, records of the international agreements, but the Kyoto Protocol was the first one I worked for directly. So that's why that was a pretty touching moment. And I always dreamed about working for the UN and international process. So this is kind of a great coincidence for me, working for the climate change even for 17 years since then, but still like working on the same issue. So this is very good. And also thanks to the Kyoto Protocol, which, I mean, that moment I observed, protocol was adopted. That still like, you know, the quite impressed, also quite like moved about that moment. Well, actually, my funniest moment always associated with the dancing. And that happened in many different places, but actually one of the memorable moments was in Copenhagen, because when I had a chance to co-chair the technology contact group under the AWG LCA, together with the current ADP co-chair, Kishan Kumarasinghe, and because the negotiation was quite tense and everybody started to shout against each other, so I decided to, like, you know, tell them to stand up, and I put my iPhone plug to the computer and put the volume maximum. So I asked them to dance. So like for the 5 to 10 minutes that they start to dance and they laugh a lot. So that's why the other negotiating groups were quite wondering as to what exactly happening next door. And they came to see us, and also they even jump in and also just, you know, join us dancing. So I think that softens the moment and softens the feelings among the negotiators. That was the second week, so that was pretty tense. At the time, well, I've been always wearing the different and also funny headgears in the negotiations. And sometimes I wore the polar bear hat, and sometimes I had some Spanish, really arrogant hat. So that's why that's kind of tradition that negotiators, like especially EU negotiators, always bring me something different for each session. So that tradition still continues. Well, actually, that also coincides with the COP15 time, especially on the way back from Copenhagen due to the heavy snow and also snowstorm. I flew via Paris, but my flight to Tokyo from Paris was delayed by 7 hours. So I was completely tired, and also I went to the Air France lounge, and I finished the 7 bottles of wine before I just jumped on the Tokyo flight. And after that, I don't remember anything. So I think that year was really, really tough. The ideal scenario is actually if I can see very clearly what we agreed, and also especially I can see the foresee like a 2050 from that agreement, that would be great. So the what and also who going to be do what by when. And that's, I think, a huge question. But I would say the best scenario is, unlike the Kyoto Protocol, I would say, in the future, I don't want to renegotiate everything from the scratch. So that agreement can stay until 2050, could be like even longer, with some condition we have to review every 10 years, every 5 years. But I think that some protocol or legal agreement should stay almost forever. And I would like to celebrate that with the other negotiators who've been together, including Madame Bernadette Mueller, been together for about 17, 18 years together working. Always like, you know, we call ourselves a veteran or a ghost in the climate change negotiation. And of course, I also would like to celebrate that with Mr. Thomas Becker, who had to leave before the COP15, but who has been a great friend of me and who has great confidence in me. So I also would like to have a nice wine with Thomas when I see the great agreement in Paris. Of course, I mean, with my newlywed wife as well. Well, that's a huge question, but you know, based on what I have been observing quite recently in the ADP process or SBI or SAPSTA, other like a negotiated group, I mean, it has been quite negative. I mean, I worry a lot about the Paris. But besides that, maybe like Paris has a magic because of the city power, because of the power of the French people, or because of the we all love the Paris. So hopefully we can see much more clarity in Paris. So in that sense, I try to be cautiously optimistic for the outcome from Paris.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.